Hi everyone, how are you? It's Dr. Splickle, functional podiatrist and human movement specialist. I'm here to speak to you about custom orthotics. So I know that there's a lot of controversy on the internet about orthotics. Do we actually need them? No, get them out of our shoes. They are a crutch. Our foot is not designed for orthotics. Hold on. Now, before we even go down that conversation of do we need orthotics or not, I want to first go into some of the features of a custom orthotic. So now, custom orthotics, this is an example of one that I have in my office. Custom orthotics are based off of your foot's impression. So the first step of having custom orthotics that are accurate and effective is to get a good quality impression. Now there's many different ways that you could get a foot impression. One could be from a picture, a 3D scan. You can do a plaster cast, so you would do a plaster impression of the foot, or you could do one where you're stepping into this impression foam. And then that impression, whether it's digital or it's an actual physical impression, is sent to the lab. And then from there, the lab is going to make a model off of that. So you're taking this negative and then you make a positive, and from the positive you are then making the orthotic. And then the custom orthotic. The power of the custom orthotic is not based off of the impression technique. I used to think this. I used to say, anyone that uses foam, that is garbage. No, it has to be plaster molded, or it has to be a 3D scan. Really, the power of custom orthotics is in the prescription that the doctor will give the orthotic. And that is all of the different modifications that you can use and put on a custom orthotic. Now, not all custom orthotics are exactly the same. Not all companies and labs are the same. So really what you want to be doing is looking at the materials that the custom lab uses and then the modification options. So these are really important, all these different options that we could provide for a patient or an individual. Okay, now when we're looking at it, you see a custom orthotic here, right? Most important part of it is going to be the shell. So the shell of the orthotic is the hard piece that runs through a majority of that orthotic. That shell has a certain thickness, a certain flexibility. This is where specificity gets to come in. Do you want to use a really thick, stiff, rigid shell that has no flexion in it? Maybe. Or are you trying to use something that's going to compress and then bounce back? Those are options that you have in custom orthotics. So not all custom orthotics are super stiff, rigid orthotic shells. That's based off of the prescription that is given for that patient. Now, the purpose of the shell, as you can see, I'll show you the medial side, is that there's a built-in arch. So it's obviously lifting the medial side of the foot, specifically your navicular bone. So it's trying to lift the arch of the foot by giving it some mechanical support. Now again, before you get too excited there, is that some of the shells can actually have some flexion to them, which allows what's called arch compression. So in my runners that I want to use custom orthotics, I use a shell that has more of a flex to it, a thinner shell as well, so that they can use this optimized arch compression for elastic energy return. Right, that would be a purpose behind that prescription. Now, outside of that shell, the next most important part is going to be the heel. So this is looking at what is called a post. Now, the post is the correction that you give to the heel or the subtalar joint. Now, your subtalar joint, your heel, which is gonna invert and evert, right? If you could imagine that with my hand, inversion to the outside of the heel, eversion to the inside of the heel. These posts can have a wedge or an angulation to them, and they are essentially pushing the foot into more inversion, is usually what's done, into inversion, and then that inversion pulls your foot into a more supinated, higher arch position, and now you are more stable. So it is another way to control foot excess mobility or excess pronation. Now, here we go. There's different types of posts. You can have a extrinsic post, which is what this is. Do you see how bulky this is? Okay, so that extrinsic post, or you can have one that is intrinsic. So it wouldn't have this bulky piece under it. It would be just the shell, and then it would be skived within it. So if your other opinion of custom orthotics is that they're always bulky and they don't fit in my shoes, I have to wear sneakers if I want to wear custom orthotics. Not true. Not true at all. That means that the doctor that prescribed those orthotics did not take that into consideration. You can make very low profile, medial skived orthotics so that you could wear them in a ballet flat, into loafers, in men's dress shoes. So you always have these options. Okay, now you get better control with an extrinsic post. So if you have a severe overpronated foot, you might need that extrinsic post, which is going to make the orthotic a little bit bulkier. It's the trade-off, okay? Now, that correction of that post, again, you're gonna see a little bit of a wedge. It's gonna throw that foot into more of an inversion, and then that lifts the arch, okay? So those are two ways that you can control a foot through an orthotic. Now, other thing you can add to the heel, you could add a heel lift. So let's say on this side, that red, maybe I have two orthotics next to each other and that little red addition, maybe that's the heel lift that's built in for a patient that has a limb length discrepancy. Could be the case, right? And that would be built into the orthotics. Easy to do that. Now, some other modifications that we can add to this is there's something along here, which is like a little wall. It's called a flange, a medial flange. It's like a wall, and it prevents the foot from spilling inward. In a severe overpronated foot, you might need a flange. It's like a wall on that medial side. But guess what that does? It makes your orthotic bulkier, which means you gotta wear them in sneakers or something that's a wider shoe. But that flange is used in a lot of my patients that have post-tib tendon tears or really chronic overpronation and flat foot pathology. They might actually need to have that flange. Okay, that's another option. Now, when you look at this, some other great options is that you can get a metatarsal pad built into it that's gonna open up the foot. You can do different cutouts on the bottom. You actually wouldn't cut out the fabric, it would be built within. So you can offload the first, maybe if you have sesamoiditis or you have functional hallux limitus. You could offload the second if you have any second MPJ issues. You could use something for neuromas to open up the foot. So there's a lot of modifications in the forefoot that you can do in custom orthotics, which is great. And then the last thing that I want to talk about has to do with the length. So you can choose that top cover, it can go all the way to the end. It could go so it's just about here to the sulcus, or it would be just the shell. All of those. And that has to do with what shoes you're putting them in. So I like custom orthotics for certain conditions and certain patients. But what I always say is that it is the power of the prescription of what makes a custom orthotic effective. It is also a deep understanding of human movement and functional movement to get a custom orthotic that works for the patient. What type of shoes are they going to wear them in? What is the activity? What is their foot type? What is their foot pathology? What is their injury history? So you can make some really friendly, quasi-natural foot function supportive custom orthotics. You just have to have that deep understanding. Now, for people who look at this and then look at the Neboso insole and say, well, where's that difference? Well, one is flat. Can you appreciate that arch now in the custom orthotic, right? And then we have this stiff shell. This is not flexing. The Neboso insole, you could totally wrap that around, right? So this is going to be supporting that natural foot function. This has the shell, although we can modify the stiffness of that shell. And then if you look at these top covers, look at how inert this is. This is smooth, cottony top cover. We have our texture here. So guess what we say? If you need that biomechanical support, but you want to bring in a little bit of sensory, this is not the right foot, but you would put it on top and now you get that combination, okay? So certain people actually need custom orthotics. I'm thinking about late stage post-tib tendon issues, a hypermobile foot, chronic plantar fascial symptoms that are not resolving, tears in the post-tib tendon, maybe chronic sesamoid issues that we need to address, functional hallux limitus, maybe I need to get something so that we can control medial knee pain, maybe you're having low back pain because of hypermobility, you have limb length discrepancy, I didn't go the other way, maybe you have a supinated foot and we need to throw it just a little bit more into pronation. Many different reasons, but if you're not friendly to this and you want some increased activation of your foot, go after this, go for a combination. Understand that custom orthotics are not always bad. There's a time and place appropriateness, but you gotta get that prescription correct. If you wanna learn more about custom orthotics and maybe some of the modifications when they're appropriate, or maybe you're curious, do you need custom orthotics and you would like to get a pair of custom orthotics? I even do them with my virtual patients. I send the impression box to them. They do the impression. I teach them how to do it. We send it to the lab, and the power of the orthotic is in the prescription. Please visit Dr. Emily Splickle to learn more. If you want to learn more about the Neboso insoles, please follow Neboso on Instagram _Neboso_technology. Or go to Neboso.com. Thank you guys so much. Have an amazing day.